account of those. All right. Of course, there are a lot of people who say, well, we have to shift from commodity production to services. That's a debatable issue. Which services? And you can't replace the commodity production with services. It comes naturally over a period of time. You see, so there, I saw in the newspapers somebody say, why do we need industrialization? Where we should move to? These are not issues that can be, you know, theoretically dealt with. You have to study these things very carefully. Then, I'm going to education. Education. Well, I don't have to tell you the problems of education. The problem connected with the curriculum, the quality of teaching. Huge problem. That's a structural issue. You can't ignore this. Look at the quality of teachers. Quality of teaching. It happens not only in the schools, but also in the universities. In the, you see, in the echelons of higher learning, you have this problem. Quality of, what do you do with the quality? One thing is you build capacity through training, first selection of the people, then the training, and then also motivating them, rewarding them for high productivity. So if you don't do that, you see, you will have this problem of teaching remaining for another 10, 15 years until something really disastrous happens, when everybody will wake up to this. So education is the other most important thing which we have neglected, is education management. It's a real, utter, chaotic state. See, you can come out with all sorts of beautiful ideas about the education sector, but if you don't put the education management system right, you are in deep trouble. See, I'm saying these things not because, you see, I read some books and theories, because I have been dealing with these people. And even now, you see, I have the privilege of working very closely with people in the education and the health sector, and they both suffer from the same problem. Particularly when it comes to the health sector, again, the problem is about management. I'm sorry to say there are people from the health sector here. I must say that there are planners in the health sector who have never seen a plan. You ask them, what is planning? See, I don't know how they have been appointed. And the other problem is that, talking about the health and both the education sectors, see, they think this planning is a thing for the planning department. So the head of the institution doesn't have to bother about it. The secretary of the ministry doesn't have to bother about the planning section. He just waits for reports coming from the planning division. And the planning division, there are people who have had no training whatsoever in planning. Anyway, this is about those seven pillars that I have put there. I don't want, I can go on and on and on, and I don't want to do that because I'm sure you will have enough things to tell me about those pillars. Now, you will see that the foundation for all this is good governance. That's why I put there. You see, the vision, equity, transparency, accountability, predictability, and productivity. That's the foundation. Now, fortunately for us, we have a good, I think, may not be adequate, but a good legal framework for good governance. Actually, the 19th Amendment has provided a lot of scope for it. In addition to those, how many here? Nine. There is this Right to Information Act that is coming, which will reinforce the institutions of good government. Then you have the institutions. Now, leadership, the most important institution, is the cabinet. Now, there have been a lot of interesting articles in the newspapers about the cabinet structure.